Are you fat and depressed? Do people often mistake you for a 9-month-old pregnant woman? Wouldn't you love to have that body you've always dreamed about? Well, with Z90X, you'll have your toned abs, defined glutes, and cut arms and legs in no time at all. We'll push you to the extreme to cut that excess fat and give you that dream body. You'll be the envy of your friends. In just 3 months, just look at the progress one of our customers made. If you call in the next 10 minutes, we'll throw out a special deal. We won't just include a training regime, but also a nutrition regime to whip up your diet. Have that body of your dreams for only 20 easy payments of $29.99. Call us now at 555-555-555. Do not pass up this great opportunity to get the body you desire.
Take my money, please. Get me fit. I want to go.
So, you want to get buff?
Yes, I do. Please, teach me how to get big.
Well, first, I got to go over the basics, you know. You don't want to be that guy who just walks in and reeks of insecurity.
I remember the first time I went to the gym. I looked really stupid because I had no idea what I was doing.
Your body undergoes what is known as cellular respiration. We break down sugars to form what is known as ATP or adenosine triphosphate. This ATP is what we use as energy to power our bodies from the basics of cells to active diffusion to a more complex contraction of muscles.
But how is this all contributing to muscle growth? I don't understand it.
Well, the muscle is made of actin and myosin fibers which slide past each other using ATP. This process contracts the muscles, allowing one to lift heavy weights. Each unit of actin and myosin fibers is called a sarcomere, and between each sarcomere is a Z-line. The sarcomere is covered in the sarcoplasmic reticulum, which when activated by acetylcholine, causes the calcium ions to be released, which in turn bind to troponin, exposing myosin binding sites. Exposure allows ATP to bind and cause the actin and myosin fibers to slide past each other. Also remember that muscle cells are multinucleated, which means that they have more than one nucleus. This is important because satellite cells on the sarcolemma are activated when working out. Satellite cells are inactive cells that can be activated by muscle stress and hormones. Satellite cells that can either fuse to muscle cells and create new myofibers or donate their nuclei to the muscle and increase the muscle's capacity to create muscle fibers.
Awesome. Does that mean if I eat, I'll get really strong?
Well, you kind of got to train your muscles too. And there is a difference between being huge and strong. Ronnie Coleman, a bodybuilder and 8-time Mr. Olympia winner, could only bench 495 pounds. However, Eric Spato, a famous powerlifter, could lift 722 pounds. There are many different fields of competition. The four major ones are Olympic lifting, which focuses on explosive movements, powerlifting, which focuses on how much weight lifted in major exercises, bodybuilding, which focuses on size and conditioning, and strongman competitions, which focuses on feats of strength grip training. Despite this, there are two major training styles, strength and hypertrophy. Hypertrophy is when cells swell up. In bodybuilders, there is more sarcoplasmic hypertrophy and more cellular fluid, causing more bulk but not as much strength. However, in strength trainers, their muscles are much smaller but have more actin and myosin strands, making them stronger. If you want to get big, you have to train using the hypertrophy program, not a strength program. However, if you train hypertrophy, you will gain strength too, just not at the pace a strength trainer would, and vice versa. So now that we know the basics of training, it's time to focus on the actual training. You don't want to be the guy that shows up at the gym and only does bicep curls. When you exercise, you have to exercise in sets with rest in between. Each set has a certain number of reps in. For example, you may do 5 sets of 5 reps, which is in total 25 reps. There are 3 general different rep ranges: low,
1 to 5 reps, medium, 6 to 12, and high, 15 or more. It's been shown that 15 reps or more generally leads to no gains in muscle mass because of insufficient stress of the muscles. Low reps seem to increase strength the most, but does not have sufficient hypertrophy. The optimal range for hypertrophy is 6 to 12 reps. This is because it's been shown that low reps usually activate the phosphocreatine system, but at the same time, the medium reps activate anaerobic glycolysis, which increases the levels of lactate in both the muscles and the blood. These buildups cause the muscle to undergo muscle hypertrophy. Although the reason why is unknown, it is most likely because these buildups increase the activity of growth hormone transcription factors. Remember, when you lift, you should only lift about 75% of your max weight for one rep. From my personal experience, you know, when I bench, 75% is around 275 pounds.
275? That's eight. That's like baby weight, man. Like, come on.
Yeah, that was. You might want to go a little lighter than that. That was definitely not 75% of your max. And when lifting, you gotta work more on control. Controlling is the most important part. So now let's talk about volume. In general, bodybuilders, they need to do far more reps and sets than strength trainers do to achieve maximum hypertrophy. You should do about 4 sets for every exercise, with a few exceptions. Testosterone levels usually don't increase until after the 4th set of the exercise. Working out causes higher test and growth hormone levels. These hormones increase cell hypertrophy and helps muscular repair. It also increases amino acid uptake to make proteins. So anyways, about volume, you need different exercises to hit muscles from different angles. For example, the deltoid has the anterior, posterior, and lateral deltoid. Different exercises hit each part of the deltoid. To get the best balance, it's best to look for a supportive program online.
So the first thing you need to know is that there are 4 different categories of macromolecules: carbohydrates, lipids, proteins, and nucleic acids. The ones you have to worry about are the carbs and the lipids, which are fats, and most importantly, the proteins, since you want them to build muscle.
So are you saying all of these things come from what I eat?
Yeah, basically. Everything you eat will be digested and absorbed and will be utilized for our body through the digestive system.
Is that the thing where I eat stuff and it comes out as poop?
Sadly, but it's a bit more complex than that. Our digestive system begins in our mouth and ends at our rectum. I don't think you want me to bore you with that stuff. We're here to talk about muscles. So let me get this straight. You want to get strong fast, right?
Yes.
Alright. Well, first off, proteins are one of the most important macronutrients if you want to build muscle. Our body utilizes the amino acids of proteins as building blocks for new muscles. Even though we can get protein from whole foods such as meats, dairies, and nuts and beans, there are protein supplements that make it a bit easier, especially if you're working out. These supplements come in different forms. Beginning with what has to be the most used supplement. Whey. What is whey protein, you ask? Whey is a water-soluble milk protein composed of the byproducts of turning milk into cheese. It's a mixture of globular protein isolated from the whey, the liquid material that is a byproduct of cheese production. Whey is the most popular protein supplement on the market. It promotes lean muscle growth and fat loss. Not only that, but it supports cardiovascular health and healthy metabolism. It even improves immune function. A complete protein powder supplement will contain all 10 essential amino acids. We can synthesize 11 out of the 21 amino acids. Essential amino acids are the amino acids that our body can't synthesize because we lack the enzymes required for the biosynthesis. Keep in mind that whey powder digests really fast in your body, making it an optimal post-workout shape. Moving on from whey, casein has no disulfide bridges, which results in relatively little tertiary structure. At the same time, it's hydrophobic, making it poorly soluble in water. Unlike whey, casein powder will take a while to digest. All of its other attributes are the same as whey.
Well, if they're both the same, which one's better?
Even though the two types of protein powders are similar, whey contains more leucine, while casein is higher in glutamine. Leucine is a key amino acid for activating protein synthesis. Glutamine, on the other hand, is also important in protein synthesis. Glutamine is depleted in blood plasma and muscles after exercise. Bottom line, to maximize the anabolic period for muscles, you should drink whey powder directly after working out. You should aim for 30% of your daily caloric intake to be protein.
Sweet. Is there any other supplements that can help me build muscle fast?
These things are what are known as pre-workouts. Pre-workouts will give you the edge in training by ramping up your energy and endurance, increasing your strength, and cranking up your muscle growth and burning off body fat. Finally, creatine is one of the most used supplements out there. Creatine is a nitrogenous organic acid that is found in the muscle tissue in the form of phosphocreatine and supplies energy for muscle contractions. Creatine gives us more energy by donating a phosphate to ADP, which is adenosine triphosphate. After it has been hydrolyzed by the muscle, ATP, adenosine triphosphate, is what we use as energy, and creatine takes ADP and converts it back to ATP to supply our body with the energy we need. Creatine makes muscle hypertrophy possible. Okay. Remember, too much of anything can be bad for you, and it's important to have a healthy and balanced diet if you want any sort of muscle growth to occur. It's nice doing business with you. And good luck on your workout.
Hey, what's up, man? Have you been working out, dude? You look pretty good.
You know, just pretty a solid. Little here and there.
Yeah, yeah. You know what would make you look even better, though? You know, just some steroids right here. Probably right here, too.
I don't know about that.
I mean, come on, man. Just think about it. Come on. First one's free, dude.
I'm going to ask my doctor about that.
Dude, who are you going to trust, dude? A guy with a PhD, who spent 4 years studying the body? Or me, who spent 4 months building the body? Come on, bro.
Are there any side effects?
Nah, dude, there's no side effects. Don't worry about it.
What are the side effects of steroids? Let's see.
Side effects include mood swings.
Shrinkage of testicles.
What the? Nah, it has to be the cold.
Psychosis? Many other mental and physical symptoms?